The sun, our fiery, beautiful life source. Without it, life on planet Earth would never have evolved. From it, we take heat, solar energy, and vitamin D. But what would happen if the queen bee of our solar system disappeared? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that looks to answer a number of queries, ranging from the downright insane to the sometimes actually pretty reasonable. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate, and today I'm asking, what if the sun disappeared in 7 days. Before we get into all this drama, I want to ask you guys what you would do if you knew you only had 7 days left on Earth. What a loaded question. Also, if you like our videos, I want to remind you that we love it when you leave a thumbs up. If you guys want to connect with me or the creative team behind this video, there are links to all of our social medias in the description box down below. So, if the sun disappeared in 7 days, whoa. For a moment, let's just ignore the how and the why and address the what if part of our question. If the sun went out today, right now, in this very second, it would take between 8 and 8.5 minutes for us to even realize. The sun is 93 million miles away, and light can only travel so fast. At the speed of light, not so coincidentally. Our death blow would take us almost 10 minutes to reach us, which is time enough to watch this video, pop the kettle on, eat a sandwich, however you'd like to spend the last 8 minutes of your life. I suppose what would happen during and after those 8 minutes would depend on whether or not we saw it coming. If we knew the sun was about to die in 7 days, there'd be utter chaos, which may be a reason for any scientist who may have seen it coming simply not to tell us. At this point, I suppose it's a question of ethics. Do we have a right to know our fate, and does knowing we have a week to live make the end better or worse? While knowing I had a week until the apocalypse would be a good heads up for me, time enough to travel back to England to my family, the chances are everyone on the planet would be in a state of flux, and the airports would be closed down anyway. The roads would be gridlocked. If we knew there were just 7 days, would there not be anarchy across the world? So what would happen 1 week and 8 minutes in when the sun actually totally disappeared from our sphere of recognition? No light. No nothing. Not only would it take 8 minutes for light and heat to disappear, but it would also take 8 minutes for our Earth to stop orbiting the spot where the sun used to be. After that, we will be flung off in a straight line, as will other planets in our solar system, so let's just hope we don't smash into them. The big question is, can we survive without the sun? While things would be pretty and very literally dark, we wouldn't just die straight away. The first week would be alright, actually. Global temperatures would drop to 0 degrees Celsius, which we can cope with shelter. Trust me, I live in Canada, the winters are harsh. But yes, we know that most animal life does need warmth. Electricity would continue so long as it was still being generated, so we may be able to heat ourselves sufficiently for a while. But we would need a plan fast, as within a year, global temperatures would drop even further to minus 100 degrees Celsius. There is heat to be found at the core of our planet, but it is hard to drill that far down, although going underground may be our only option.
This is a rapper. Not bad. Matter of fact, it's the best burger I've had in years.
Gracias, señor.
Prego.
We could all try and move to Iceland and harness their geothermic energy, but whether that would sustain us, I don't know. Within months, the oceans would freeze, trees would freeze, our cities would be trapped beneath vast sheets of ice. While plant life would stop photosynthesizing after the 8 minutes and die out within a week, we still just about have enough oxygen to last us for 1,000 years on Earth, so long as it doesn't freeze, although likely it would. So basically, the Earth would be a frozen tundra, with the only life being microorganisms who survive in the small amount of liquid water left at the bottom of the ocean near hydrothermic vents. Fun, sure, but there is a silver lining. In around 43,000 years, Earth would reach the nearest star, 4.3 light years away. If we started orbiting that, maybe the grand deep thaw would begin and the microorganisms who are still surviving and thriving would start evolving. But I have to say, unless we meet alien neighbor mates who can revive our cold, dead, frozen corpses, it isn't looking so great for humans. But But of course, we know that the sun can't really just disappear. Even if at its very core it stopped fusing hydrogen suddenly and unpredictably, and for all intent and purposes simply went out, it would take about 10,000 years for us to realize, during which time civilizations could rise and fall. After that, we would gradually start to succumb to its lowering temperatures. But of course, we already know the sun's fate, and it isn't what we've discussed so far. What is actually going to happen is this. We know that nothing lasts forever, and that our sun really will go out, so to speak, one day. Although that is different to disappearing. Even to say it will simply go out is pretty flippant. The sun isn't a switch. We can't turn it on or off. But it is an energy source bigger than we can imagine that, yes, one day will start to deplete. In reality, the process of the sun going out takes billions of years. The sun is in the middle of its life phase right now. In around 5 billion years' time, it will have made its dramatic final demise. Things will start to kick off in the next billion years. In 1.1 billion years, the sun may have expanded by 10%, making its rays hotter and brighter to the Earth. This is the point where, if there is any life left as we know it on Earth, it will be having to bow out. The oceans will boil, and the Earth will become irreparably scorched. In 3.5 billion years, the sun will be 40% brighter, then eventually it will reach full red giant stage. This process from start to finish can take a few billion years, but when the sun is done being a red giant, it will begin with the planetary nebula phase, which lasts tens of thousands of years and sees the sun shed a glowing shell of hot gas. After this, only the core will remain, and while it's hot, it will be called a white dwarf star, but eventually, when it's cool, it will be a black dwarf star. A cold, dead rock floating in space. This is the only fate for our sun. So, sun chat. What a great time. I actually kind of enjoyed this video despite it being pretty dark. I hope you guys did too. Either way, let me know your thoughts in the comments section down below. Also, don't forget to let me know what you would do if you just had 7 days left to live. Ooh. Also, if you guys like our videos, why don't you click on that notification bell so you never miss a big answer. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. I'm going to get out of here to enjoy this beautiful sunny day, so I'll catch you in the next video. But until then, stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.